Hi everyone, I'm Cody, W3AMG with BridgeCom Systems, and today we're going to be showing you the band error, how it happens, and then also how to fix it. This can happen if you have a Super Code Plug, Ultra Code Plug, or just about any other code plug you downloaded from somewhere. Sometimes you can run into this. So first, let's go ahead and duplicate the problem so we can see what we're looking at. So I've got my radio here. We'll plug in the programming cable. I have myself a code plug that it's actually a code plug of mine, an older code plug, but we'll just pretend I got it, downloaded it from somewhere, or it could also be an ultra code plug or a super code plug. So let's go ahead and go in here. I'm gonna open up my CPS. Awesome, here we go. So I'm going to go ahead and open that code plug. So press the open button and we will open the file. Here we go. So here's the code plug in question. So I'm going to go ahead and open that. Now it's going to open in here just fine. Shouldn't have any trouble there. Once it does, we're going to write that to the radio. What's going to happen in this case, because I already know the way it's set up, this code plug was actually written on an older band plan, so it won't write into the radio correctly. Now this could accidentally happen to you, so we'll show you how to fix it. So just go ahead and click OK. Now we'll wait for the, yep, radio's connected. So just go ahead and write those to the radio, just like you would do if you're trying to install a code plug. Oh, band error. This is a classic problem, happens to a lot of folks. So if you run into this problem, generally it's because the code plug was written in a different band plan than your radio. Now, if you don't want to change the band plan, which probably is not the right solution for you, it's very simple to actually transfer over that information. So in your CPS, just go ahead and hit OK. We have the code plug loaded in the software now. So what you'll do is go up to Tool, and we'll actually go to Export. Now you can choose to export a lot of the information here. Generally, I have had the best luck just exporting the channel list, and then maybe the zone list as well. Sometimes things can get a little bit funky if you do everything. So I'm gonna export the channel list here. You can do an export all, just use your own judgment on that. Sometimes talk groups don't come across properly. And if it doesn't work, you can always come back and do it again. But I usually like to do the channel and then maybe a couple of the others if I want to add them as well, such as the talk groups. So we'll go ahead and do this and just save this somewhere on your computer. So we can save this to the desktop. We'll give it a name, here. Awesome, go ahead and save that. And go ahead and export that. Just click the export button. There we go, export complete. Now what we're going to do is just go ahead and read from your radio. So you'll want to go here to the read from radio button to the left of the COM port button. Click on it. We don't need to worry about saving changes unless there's anything you need to save. Then click OK. And in this case, just the other data, that should be fine. And we're going to read from the radio. Now what this is doing, and this is a good procedure before you make any changes on CPS in general, is to always read from your radio. That's going to sync everything together, and now your computer is on the same page as your radio when it comes to the band plan, and that will eliminate the band plan error in the first place. So once we've done this, there we go, awesome, we've read from our radio. Now what you can do is go back to Tool, go to Import, just click OK. Now if you exported everything, you can do Import All and import that LST file. Now in this case, we just did the channel, so click on Channel. And where's our new, there we go, there's the list we exported, gave it a name. So go ahead and open that back up and click import. Now what it's going to do is import all those channels and all that data into our radio without changing any band plans or anything like that. So import complete. Awesome, there we go. So at this point, it's just a matter of making sure our radio is still connected, which it is. And go ahead and write that information over to your radio.